Is this the last item, Mr. Chairman?
It is. It is.
Mr. Chairman and members of the board, by way of amendment, I wanted to bring to you basically a 8-minute policy discussion involving the ethics ordinance, and I have basically some general 10,000-foot issues I want to ask you about, and then I want to bring to your attention one issue of a particular potential change to the code. You know, Mr. Chairman, I don't think it's lost on anybody that in the last year or so there have been a lot of issues involving the ethics ordinance. Not only has the board recently or in the not too remote future taken some unilateral action to modify the ethics code, you know, we've adopted the wrongful use provisions, et cetera. Those were unilateral. When I say unilateral, I mean they were not at the urging or request of the ethics board itself. And then, of course, we've made some changes that were requested by the ethics board. And have done that as well. And right now, on your February 2nd agenda, we have yet additional modifications made by or requested by the ethics board, quite frankly, with some input from myself as well. And to the extent that the ethics ordinance is challenging to comply with, is challenging procedurally, and presents some, I guess you'd say, some administrative hurdles. That's a county problem. That's a problem with me, to the extent that that exists. I don't know what the answer is, and to the extent that, you know, the Board of Commissioners would like to maybe have me reach out to the Board of Ethics and see if we need to start a dialogue and perhaps some much more substantive changes to the entirety of the code, maybe in fact a new paradigm with respect to how it's done. Maybe they could provide us some input on that. Maybe you'd like me to go out and speak with them and bring you back some recommendations. I wanted to have this discussion. I don't know that we have set the table with 7 minutes left for this discussion to occur.
I think it's worth considering, you know, some sort of certification for them. If you're a member of the ethics board, just throwing that out there, that counselor, you're well versed in this statutes, and you know, when you get appointed or nominated to the ethics board,
Well, I don't have to tell any of you that the stakes are high. I mean,
this
you know, an ethics board is a good board. The ethics ordinance is a big deal, and those who administer it have a big responsibility, and we need to make sure that we give them the tools to succeed and to do it right, and to make sure that those that are in the process are treated fairly. I think that's everyone's objective, and to the extent that that's not happening, if you perceive that's not happening, then I need to help you and the board make that happen. So I want to lay that out to you, and we may not have time to get into the weeds on this today. This may be an item for the next work session. If it is, let's postpone that, but I want to at least raise it. It's out there. Yes, sir.
Thank you, Counselor. Do you think that this is an item that maybe, you know, February 14th, what, 3 weeks away? Do we need another work session between now and the 14th?
There's two issues that, and I don't mean to suggest this elevates to the water contract. I'm sorry, I don't think it's there, but there are a couple of issues I heard today that suggest to me may need some interaction between the next 3 weeks or within the next 3 weeks. Water contract is.
I think the board ought to consider, you know, maybe one on the 7th, or moving the 14th up to the 7th instead of waiting 3 weeks. I think that's just adding. If we knock it out on the 7th, we don't have to come on the 14th. Well, this
way the days of the month work out.
Do I hear a motion?
Well, that's the week we've got the work session and the regular meeting in the same week. It would be helpful to staff, if it makes sense to the board, to move the 14th to the 7th.
How about all these things we delayed to the 14th? We have to go back and do them, or can't?
Things we've delayed to the 14th, if you call a special meeting, I think within our rules, you could add agenda items, and at that meeting, we could take them off the 14th. Okay. Just add them in the ordinance.
Yeah. Let's do that.
Why don't we just do
that? Yeah, let's just have a work session.
What's this other one?
Well, the other issue that I wanted to bring, it's not a policy issue, it's a practical issue. You know, to the extent that we rework the code, or if we are, and you've not told me that we are, but I know that I've already got some board members that don't like some of our conflict of interest transactions language, And I have proposed to you some modifications to that, and if we had time, I'd like to walk you through it very quickly before we close out the agenda. If you look, do you see that everybody have the handout that I gave you, Section 283? Section A makes a whole lot of sense. Okay, Section A provides that no official or employee shall acquire or maintain an interest in a contract or transaction if a reasonable basis exists that such an interest will be affected directly by his or her official action. Makes sense. The ethics ordinance is intended to ensure that people are making decisions objectively, correct? And so, to the extent that A says that, that makes a great deal of sense. Now go to B. Then you have a statement that says the county shall enter into a contract involving services or property with an official or employee or with a business entity in which the official or employee has an interest, period. All right, all of a sudden, B takes the element of conflict out of it. It simply is a per se carte blanche rule. And the feedback I have heard is while there may be a lot of instances where that makes sense, the rule expressed in B is inconsistent with A because A is looking to see if a true conflict exists to the extent that an official can enter into a contract. B doesn't worry about whether you have a problem or not or a conflict or not. It paints a per se rule, and to that end, perhaps it needs some modification. Okay, and that's the feedback I've heard, because what it may do ultimately is impair the ability of the county to enter into contracts that individuals that happen to be officials or employees happen to have, you know, with companies that it may make sense to do business with, even if that individual has nothing to do with the decision-making process. Does that make sense? Has no official activity whatsoever to do.
Which would create a conflict.
If they don't have any official activity with respect to the contract, then what's the conflict? That's the point that's been made to me.
In the interest of time, I'm
I'll want to go over it with you again in the public hearing in great detail, but yes, what I've tried to do is set a check and balance in here that accomplishes the ability to make sure that there's an actual conflict before someone is disqualified from doing business with the county.
Can we make motion to put this on the public hearing?
February 2nd.
I'll second that.
I made a motion
to put on the February 2nd.
Yes,
I'm second. Second question.
Well,
next meeting starts now.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to put the whole ethics thing or just this section? This section on to the February 2nd meeting. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign.
Don't need to make a motion to have a public hearing on the 7th. Work session.
Just do it and make it clean.
Well, no, yeah, and forgive me, I didn't check my calendar quick enough. Listen, I can't get it advertised by that quickly.
So you want to make it on the 7th?
I've got to have 15 days once I get the ad.
Well, we're talking about the 2nd.
No, the 7th.
There is a
work session on the 7th. I need a public hearing.
Right.
That's 15
He's
days
talking
out.
About the work. We just put something on the public hearing, and it's not enough time for him to advertise. It has nothing to do with the work session.
You all need to reconsider the vote you just took, please.
Okay. I call
make
for
a
reconsider.
Motion 16. Reconsider the previous vote.
Okay, and let's restate the motion, please.
Motion to reconsider the motion to place this on the February 2nd public hearing.
Yes, okay. Do we have a second for that?
16.
Second. We have a motion, a second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, like sign. That was no opposition. Now, can we restate?
I make a motion that we put this on February 16th. Have a public hearing on February 16th.
Second.
Okay.
We have a motion, a second. There's no discussion. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. There's no opposition. That carries. Public hearing. This is the first reading of the proposed amendment to Forsyth County Ethics Ordinance.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, this evening we have a first public reading of a proposed modification of Forsyth County Ordinance number 77, which is the Forsyth County Code of Ethics. This is something that was very briefly discussed in a prior work session. I was given the authority to proceed forward to a public hearing, of which this evening is the first. There is no opportunity to take official action with respect to this evening. These modifications consist of primarily two modifications in the conflict of interest transaction language in the code. If you look in your agenda packet on page one, you'll see a subparagraph A at the bottom, which contains a fairly clear statement that no official or employee shall acquire or maintain an interest in any contract or transaction where reasonable basis exists, that such an interest will be affected directly by his official act or action. The issue was raised to me that this carries with it the very sort of conflicted interest in official act or action which our ethics code is intended to prohibit. The language goes on further to say that the employee or official may take no action with respect to official acts or actions which the official or employee has a reasonable opportunity to influence. That is less clear with respect to meaning that, but the first section is quite clear. The whole purpose of the conflict of interest section is to ensure that official actions are taken without anything other than objective standards controlling. The concern that was raised was with respect to A and B, because B contains a much broader prohibition. The county shall not enter into any contract involving services or property with an official or employee or with a business entity in which the official or employee has an interest, period. What is omitted from that section is there being an actual conflict of interest with respect to that, and that was the issue that was raised to me, and that was what I was asked to see if we could get around or see if we could deal with. Here is the language that I have put together to try and deal with that concern. The county shall not enter into any contract involving services or property with an official or employee or with a business entity in which the official or employee has an interest, where the official or employee is obligated or authorized to take an official act or duty related to awarding or approving of that contract. Again, trying to tailor it such that the prohibition pertains to if the official has an affirmative action under law to take action with respect to that contract. This prohibition shall apply even if the official or employee abstains from taking an official act or duty with respect to the contract. The county may enter into a contract with a business entity where official or employee has an interest in the entity, so long as, number one, the official or employee has no obligation or authorization to take an official act, as we discussed. Number two, the contract is awarded by way of a competitive procurement process. Number three, the employee or official discloses to procurement personnel his or her affiliation with the county. Number four, the employee or official affirms in writing to procurement personnel that he or she is neither soliciting nor receiving any advantage, favor, or influence with respect to the contract due to affiliation with the county. And number five, the contract is not otherwise prohibited by law. Those bullet points are aimed at addressing, first of all, safeguards to ensure that if the county does in fact entertain a contract with the individual or entity that has an interest, that it's done with some transparency and with some affirmations that there's been no use of their position in the county to advance their interests in it. Mr. Chairman, this is the first reading, and there will be no opportunity to take action this evening.
Is there anyone? Do I have a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved.
Second. Motion and second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. That passes unanimously. Is there anyone who wishes to speak in favor of this item? Is there anyone who wishes to speak in opposition to this item? Please come down, sir.
My name is Harold Bennett. It's the first time I've been to a commission meeting. I've been a loyal and faithful resident of this county now for 8 years. I was 23 years a member or investigator of the medical examiner's office with the Lake County and the cop. I'm now retired from that position. The one reason I moved up here is because Forsyth County has been progressing leaps and bounds moving into the next century as far as, you know, being ahead of other areas. This particular case, though, has brought me a problem. And being quite honest, I plan on running for the position of coroner of this county in this election. I was told the day that I announced this by another person who was running that there was no need for me to run because he already had commission approval from the county attorney's approval to proceed, even though he has a county contract to operate. And him being coroner and also holding a contract with this county, I think would be in a direct conflict of interest for him, because he was saying to benefit from it financially, whether it be one time or 100 times. The difference is the way it's written. Now he cannot obtain that position because it would interfere with the way he runs his business. So he can give up his contract and run, or he can not run and keep his contract. That's, you know, that's all I have, Sarah. I'm not going to throw any names out or anything. I just wanted to bring this point up that other counties throughout the state of Georgia, and I've been dealing 23 years in the medical examiner's office, I know that this is a sore point in a lot of areas. So I'd like to see Forsyth County stay ahead of the game and not permit something like this to happen.
Thank you. Is there anyone else who wishes to speak in opposition? If not, is there a motion to close the public hearing?
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes unanimously. Old business, number one. Do we have a need of an executive session?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the issue. That passes unanimously. We are adjourned at 6:02 p.m.